This is the first part of a comprehensive guide to undervolt your NVIDIA RTX 3000 series graphics card with EVGA Precision. To begin with, we must talk about base voltage frequency curves. Curves and not curve, as there are many. For example, my current base curve is one with 1500 MHz at 800 millivolts, MHz at 900 millivolts, MHz at 1081 millivolts, namely the maximum voltage supported by my card. And finally, it tops at 2010 MHz at 1118 millivolts. The fact is, your current base curve changes over time because of the temperatures of your card and I think other variables as well. Therefore, the base curve set as soon as you turn your PC on will be better than the one set as you close a game or benchmark. By better, I mean it will have higher frequencies at the same voltages. I can easily show you this behavior by running a bench like superposition. Now, my base curve has surely changed. In fact, now I have 1485 MHz at 800 millivolts, 1710 MHz at 900 millivolts, 1935 MHz at 1081 millivolts, and finally it tops at 1965 MHz at 1125 millivolts. This means a negative difference of 15, 30, 45 and 45 MHz respectively. I've compiled a list of all of the different base curves I noticed during the normal use of my graphics card to show you how many there are. I have 18 different curves here, and certainly more exist. And here, you can see a visual representation of 6 of them. I'm going to explain why this is essential to know when undervolting. When you edit a voltage frequency point, you aren't setting a new frequency at that voltage. You are offsetting a new frequency against the old one. In other words, you are not replacing the old frequency. You are just increasing or decreasing that frequency by a number of megahertz. For example, now I'm adding a few megahertz to 1740, and now I'm subtracting a few megahertz to 1740. An implication might be evident. Let's say you want to undervolt at 900 millivolts and 1905 MHz. If you proceed when your current curve is the former, your base frequency is 1740. So you must add 165 to get 1905. But what happens when your curve develops into the latter? your base frequency decreases to 1710, while the 165 offset stays the same, so you get 1875 in the end. This is not a problem, you will lose performance, but you won't lose stability. Conversely, if you proceed when your current curve is the latter, your base frequency is 1710, so you must add 195 to get 1905. But again, what happens when your curve reverts into the former? Your base frequency increases to 1740, while the 195 offset stays the same. So you get 1935 in the end. This could be a problem. Yes, you will gain performance, but you may lose stability. Now you understand why knowing about the existence of many base curves is essential. The stability of your graphics card depends on it. The solution to this potential problem is really simple. The next time you turn your PC on, after a few hours of cooling off at ambient temperature, immediately write down all the VF points of your base curve. These values represent your best case scenario. This is mine. At 800 millivolts, I have 1500 megahertz. At 825, I have 1575. At 850, I have 1635. At 875, I have 1695. At 900, I have 1755. And so on until at 1081, I have 2010. And finally, my curve tops at 1118 millivolts and 2040 megahertz. In the second part of this guide, we are going to define the baseline performance of your graphics card, choose a VF starting point, and we'll find out how to apply a raw undervolting. Farewell for now.